after you will make pattern of your insole, you will move on to create the entire insole from cardboard. And right now I want to show you what materials you will use to create insoles. There are two types of cardboard. Texon, that is flexible and it covers the entire surface of the shoelace bottom. So from this pattern you will make this layer using the entire pattern of the insole that you made. Then comes second layer that covers approximately one half of the insole. This line passes beyond the joint line approximately in the distance of 1 centimeter. Okay, so it reaches this place approximately on the bottom of our shoelace. And using this pattern, the same one, you will cut the cardboard, the shank board that we will attach on the Texon board. Okay, so just mark lines until which will where will be the edge of the second layer. You see here is the line, and copy the outline of this pattern until this line where will be the edge of this steel shank board. Okay, now between these two layers we have the steel shank. There are many different types of steel shanks. I use this one that is already curved, you see, and it's very comfortable to work with shoelace with high heel as well as with shoelace with low heel. So you will place it here right like this. You need to check if the curve of the steel shank matches the curve of the shoelace bottom. For example, for the shoelace with high heel it fits perfectly, but when you will work with flat, with the shoelace with low heel, you will need to turn it over, flatten a little bit with the hammer, check it again by placing like this until you will reach the desirable curve, that the curve of the steel shank that will fit perfectly to the curve of the shoelace bottom. Okay, and so you will cut two parts of the insoles. First one from this Texon board, and to cut this layer you will use the entire shoe pattern, insole pattern. Second layer will be from this material. It's durable material that give us good support for the arc zone, and together with the steel shank you will have excellent support, and we will be able to make this insole for shoelace with high heels where we will need to have good support because of the heels. Okay, so all these materials will give you this support. So the second layer will be from steel shank board, from shank board, and you will need to cut only approximately one half part of this pattern of the insole. Okay, and between these two layers you will place the steel shank. Okay, that's it. Thank you and see you in the next video.